Hi guys, welcome to the first episode of Smashing Problem Sums with MRT Maths. So today I'll be showing you how to solve common problem sums, what we call in Singapore heuristics problem sums. And this particular kind, right, is called more than, less than. So basically you will have a step-by-step process. You can see the step-by-step process that I employ in solving these problem sums. And I'll take you through my signature annotation method, which will help you and your child to be able to better understand these problem sums. So in Singapore, a problem sum like this, you have to finish it in about 1 minute 50 seconds without calculator. So without further ado, let's go. So this was taken from ACS Junior 2021, last year's P5 SA2 Maths. And being question 28 is towards the end of the paper 1 already. So the first step of the annotation method requires me to actually use my pencil to do annotation. So I will circle $20 more in pencil and I'll point to Jack. Then how do I know that this question is actually talking about more than, less than? You can actually see it in the question itself. They actually have the words more than. And in the question, Jack gave $32 to Tim. So this is a very important information. That's why I underline it. Then they say that Tim had 3 times as much money as Jack. So 3 times, 3 units, will be pointed to Tim. And as you can see for Jack, this character appears after the second S. So in this sentence, right, Tim had 3 times as much money as Jack. So Jack appeared after the second S. We can say that for whole number questions like this, Jack will be 1 unit. And after giving us the backstory, the final thing that they want from us, right, is how much money did Jack have at first. So what they want from us is Jack at first. So we are almost done with the annotation. And I would like to share with everyone here who are watching this, is that there are many children in Singapore, they actually dive straight into the problem sum. So we don't advise for students to do that, because when they do that, they do not have a complete understanding of the problem sum itself. So to enhance the problem sum solving process and to enhance our understanding, I actually get my students to use the highlighter as well. So there are many children out there who actually highlight this way. So as you can see, when I'm using the highlighter to underline or to cover up my words, I wouldn't be able to see what is behind those words. So instead of doing that, I use multiple colors, namely the Byrog method, B-Y-R-O-G. And that is actually to make things more interesting for my brain, to make things more memorable, and I believe that will enhance my understanding of the problem sum. So blue for the first important information, yellow for the next one, then red showing that Tim actually has as much money as Jack, orange what they actually want from us, Jack at first. So now I'll go into the model drawing. I will show you the nitty gritty as to how it's done. So model drawing is actually very simple. I got to use pencil. I shouldn't draw the model too near to my question, because I will need some working space. And I've not been using the ruler to draw models for the last 16 years that I've been teaching maths. So you don't need a ruler, you can just get it done easily, freehand. But just do ensure that your rectangle looks like a rectangle. Then in my question itself, they actually say Jack had $20 more than Tim, so I'm going to show that. So some common errors. There are many children who actually, when they know that they are going to move $32 from Jack to Tim, they take the 32 directly from the brown box. So please don't do that. If you do so, your 20 will be left hanging in the air. So the correct way is that we got to move the 20, the extra number that is poking out in my model, I move it downwards from Jack to Tim. So Tim received the 20, and after doing so, I got to ask myself this important question. After moving $20, how much more money must I move from Jack to Tim? And the answer will come in the form of taking 32 minus 20. So I got to move another 12. As everyone can see here. And I also remind my students, if there's a space on top, the space above is 12, the space below must be 12 as well. So my next step is that after that I've taken the 12, I've shown in my model, I'll need to have this thing called a swing arrow. So this swing arrow is extremely important, is to show that I have moved 12 over from Jack to Tim. And having done that, it's time for me to finish up the problem. So we know that in the end, Jack is one unit because Jack appeared after the second S. Then what about Tim? So the trick to solving this question well is to draw two braces. You can call it a bracket, but I'll call it the brace by the official name. So Tim is 3 units in the end. Then I always ask my students this particular P1 question. So 1 unit plus how many units give us 3 units? So that's actually 2 units. So 2 units is actually 12 plus 20 plus 12. And when I add them all up, it's actually 44. So there are also many setters of maths questions. They will make it such that when you add up these 3 numbers, right, they are actually a multiple of 3, just to trick you. So don't fall into the trap. Then having done that, I'll need to find 1 unit. And if you realize why did I circle the 2, is to remind myself what should I divide the 44 by. So I'll take 44 divided by 2, and that gets me to 22. So called a nice number. Yeah. Then the question wants us to actually find Jack at first. So Jack at first, very simple. Is simply just adding 1 unit, which is 22 with 12 and then with 22. So Jack at first is 22 plus 12 plus 20. And since this paper 1, I can't use the calculator, but this is actually very simple. I can actually add them up, do a simple working, or I can even do mental sum. So 22 plus 12 is 34, plus 20 will be 54. So I've been telling my students for the past 16 years that getting the answer is not the only thing. We got to learn how to check. And for checking, the best way of checking is not to redo the question all over again or to work backwards, but to use another way to get to the answer. So this question is very simple. So to check, I will make use of Tim. So since 1 unit is 22, Tim in the end will be 3 units. 3 units will be 22 times 3, which gets me to 66. And I realized that if I were to remove away the 12, which I just drew across, I'll be able to find Jack at first. Okay? So Jack at first is none other than 66. Minus 12, and I'll be able to arrive at 54. And upon seeing this in the exam, this will surely bring a bright smile to my face. Okay, so once again, thank you everyone for watching. Hope to see you again for smashing problem sums with MRT Maths. This is Teacher Ray signing off. Thank you. Bye-bye.